The father and son have told Nine News at the moment they saved a drowning kangaroo from the rising flood waters at Renmark. The heartwarming rescue was captured on camera, and the men, who'd been tending to their houseboat, now called wildlife heroes.
Kim and Billy McConnell didn't think twice when they spotted a kangaroo struggling to stay afloat in flood waters.
Jumped in there and, you know, done the Baywatch thing and...
Outback Wrangler
and went to rescue the roo.
I sort of had like a little lasso thing whipped up, and Dad says, you know, that's no good. He says, just grab it by the scruff of the neck. And as I reached over and grabbed it, there was like 0% body fat, and it just slipped straight out of my hands and went to Dad's side.
But the father and son were undeterred by their failed attempts, desperate to save it from drowning.
He just grabbed it by the ears.
He went under quite a few times, and we thought that he was finished, quite frankly.
Kim holding on to the distressed animal for dear life as his son guided their tinny back towards Renmark's riverbank.
I think he's going to be pretty worn out.
Eventually arriving to shore, the kangaroo slowly hopping onto dry land.
Yay!
He's hopped and turned around, and he looking like he was trying to either fight us or he was saying thanks.
Or he was a bit upset with Dad for grabbing hold of his ear holes and pulling them off. Yeah, me and my brother and my sister know what that feeling's like.
Which it was, the kangaroo, we'll only ever know. But with it watching on as its saviours left...
Well done.
They were left with only one feeling.
You felt quite good about it, really.
Yeah, we were quite chuffed with it by the end of the day. You know, we saved something, get a bit of good karma back. And, we made a bit of an adventure. We can't jet ski in the river at the moment, so saving the wildlife was the next best thing.
Kate Lamb, Nine News.
Authorities are telling residents along the River Murray to get their plans ready to leave their homes. New modelling shows a further rise is due early next week. And following an extensive door-knocking survey, it's become clear hundreds of people want to stay even once floodwaters arrive.
They knew it was coming, but they weren't expecting this. The full might of the Murray, too much for this Barmera property.
There's an inevitability that they will have these low-lying communities and properties that are on the floodplain that just simply cannot be protected.
Further downstream at Wongulla, a similar site, with no amount of levees or sandbags able to protect these homes from what was coming. Many piling up furniture on their balconies, but new modelling suggests that might not be high enough.
Modelling is a complex exercise, and trying to forecast the way the river will respond to an event that hasn't happened in 50 years.
Predictions for the first and second peak have both been increased, with the first hitting towns along the river from next week.
Because the water has spread out so much at the border where the gauges are measured, there's water running around, and so the measurement that is taken at the border, those gauges, is actually underestimating the actual flow.
The Premier returning to the Riverland today to hear from impacted locals, including those who had their power turned off with no warning. Emergency services continuing their work, inspecting levees and door-knocking homes. Already more than 5,000 properties have been visited, but more than 600 are choosing to stay put.
I do know some of them plan on sticking around, and we're trying to work out plans on how to get them out when it is that point of being too late.
While others have decided the time is right to say their farewells.
We've come to say goodbye.
In its current format, yeah. We've owned the shack since 95, and this is the first time we've seen anything like this. Our family has Easter every year at the shack. We've already written off Easter.
Residents here at Walker Flats say in the last few days they've really started to notice the water encroaching on their homes, and they're extremely worried about what's to come. They say it could be months before they're able to safely return and start that lengthy clean-up. Will?
Cam Inglis, thank you.